Orthocell Managing Director Paul Anderson is with us this morning. Good morning, Paul.
Good morning, Alicia. Thanks for having me.
Paul, for new members of our audience, can you provide a quick overview of Orthocell's position in the global regenerative medicine market?
Yeah, thanks, Alicia. So Orthocell is a regenerative medicine company, and we work in what's called the musculoskeletal area. And effectively, musculoskeletal represents the framework of our body, our muscles, our tendons, our bones, and our nerves. So we're a regenerative medicine company. We're focused on the musculoskeletal space, and in particular, bone, nerve, and tendon tissue.
So the news yesterday was you've secured a global license and the manufacturing agreement, and it's an exclusive one, for your recently FDA-cleared dental product, which is known as Striate Plus. So walk us through exactly what this deal means and why it's so important to the Orthocell team.
Yeah, so this is an exclusive global license and distribution agreement with BioHorizons, one of the largest dental companies in the world today. So this is a very important milestone for our company. It brings a significant upfront payment, a non-diluting capital in a time when the market is a very tough market to be raising capital. So this is a really defining moment for our company in that it provides us we've got $32 million at hand in the bank today, and provides us with the opportunity to really drive the pipeline products that we have, you know, for nerve and tendon towards the FDA market as well. So tremendous milestone for our company. Not only does it provide non-diluting capital, but it also really turns us into a mature global manufacturer.
Now, a product like this doesn't come to fruition overnight, and Orthocell's been working with a number of key and leading dental surgeons to make this product happen. Tell me, why is BioHorizons such an important partner for you as you lead this global commercialization?
Yeah, so if you look at the global dental business, about 85% of the global market is held by the top five or six companies in the world. And so if you want to really penetrate those markets to any depth, you really need to partner with the large end of town. But of course, you can't do that unless you have a quality product, a product that's at a premium level to meet the needs of patients, the needs of dentists, and the needs of these large dental corporations. So Orthocell's been working very diligently over the last 2.5 years in particular to bed down our key opinion leader group, to have validation of this technology in the US, in Europe, and in Australia, and really providing us with a foundation to have meaningful discussions with meaningful partners. So as I mentioned previously, this is a tremendous milestone for our company. It gives us access to the global market like we wouldn't have dreamed of previously. And of course, brings that non-diluting capital into the company. So tremendous position for us right now.
Now, you mentioned that this deal is a milestone for Orthocell, but it also has impacts for the Australian medtech sector at large. What is the economic impact of deals like this when they're done?
Look, I think it's really important to understand with this deal that Orthocell's done with BioHorizons is that we haven't sold the farm. And what we've been able to do is to maintain the manufacturing of this product within this country. And so we believe there's a strong net national benefit associated with this deal. We're slated to hire 7 new hires in the next 12 months from a technical perspective, to manufacture the product, to scale up. And so we've been very fiercely determined to maintain our manufacturing base in this country, retain the knowledge and know-how that enabled us to manufacture these products, and to also assist us in helping the development of further products within the portfolio. So this is a real portfolio play for our company, and it's a tremendous fillip for the local manufacturing scenarios here in Australia. High quality, high end, premium manufacturing of biological products for dental, orthopedics, and plastic reconstruction applications.
So this really sets the pace for commercialization across the portfolio that you mentioned. What exactly can investors look forward to within the next 12 to 18 months from Orthocell?
Yeah, look, I think that's really important to understand that we'll be working with our partner BioHorizons to scale up our manufacturing to enable us to move from 10,000 units per year to over 110,000 units per year. And that, of course, has a really strong flow-on effect to our other product portfolios. And I think it's really important to note that in March of this year, Orthocell received a TGA clearance to market our nerve repair product for peripheral nerve repair called Remplier. And so this is now a product which has been moving into the market. We're looking at partnering with some of the very best partners in the Australian market to growing our revenue base, to taking market share from our competitors and potential acquirers. And so what we're going to see over the next 18 months in particular is a really solid news flow, both around our Remplier product for nerve repair as we move into the FDA process, but also here in Australia. So tremendous amounts of news to follow this really impactful and important announcement around our relationships with BioHorizons.
Paul Anderson, Managing Director at Orthocell. Thanks for providing this update on a strategic announcement. We look forward to hearing from you again shortly.
Thanks, Alicia. A pleasure as always.